Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the graduation ceremony for the graduates of the Faculties of Arts, Education and Law. In a few minutes, the graduation ceremony will commence. The procession of dais and staff parties will enter. I will signal to you when you are to rise and remain standing until all members of the staged party are seated. May I take this opportunity to request that you turn off all mobile phones and pagers, and may I also remind you that flash photography is prohibited within this auditorium. Ladies and gentlemen, the Chancellor, Ms. Lenine Ford, will now address us.
The Honourable Chief Justice Andrew Lee, Chief Justice of Hong Kong. Professor Bill Lovegrove, Acting Vice Chancellor. Councillor Don Critchlow, the Gold Coast City Council. Members of the Griffith University Council, distinguished guests, colleagues, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, it is the custom for Griffith University and its guests to gather and celebrate the conferral of academic awards on its graduates. So on behalf of the Council of the University, I'm pleased to extend a very warm welcome to everyone present for this graduation ceremony. This occasion holds special significance for our graduates. This afternoon, in the presence of family, friends, and the entire university community, your dedication and hard work are recognized and rewarded. I'd like to extend a very special welcome to the Honorable Chief Justice Andrew Lee, Chief Justice of Hong Kong. He will receive the university's honorary degree, Doctor of the University, and will deliver this afternoon's occasional address. Griffith is one of the largest multi-campus universities in Australia and is formed by an integrated network of six campuses stretching from South Bank on the Brisbane River to here on the Gold Coast. From these campuses, Griffith serves the higher education needs of its students and its related communities in the Brisbane Gold Coast region, as well as nationally and internationally. The Gold Coast is Griffith's fastest growing campus and one of the most modern in Australia. Since 1990, Griffith University has invested more than $110 million in the development of teaching and research facilities at our Gold Coast campus to both meet local demand for tertiary study and to support the region's economic development initiatives. Nearly 8,000 students, including about 1,200 fee-paying international students, are enrolled in one of the 51 undergraduate or 46 postgraduate degree programs on offer. It is also host to leading research bodies, including the Cooperative Research Center in Sustainable Tourism, the Center for Coastal Management, and the Center for Ecotourism Research. As an active member of the Gold Coast community, Griffith is concerned that residents of this region do not enjoy the same level of access to higher education as other parts of Australia. Griffith is pursuing a campaign to lobby the Commonwealth Government to increase by 3,000 the number of publicly funded student places allocated to this Gold Coast region. If successful, this will bring the number of student places allocated to this region up to the national average. Now, this campaign has the strong support of prominent local business and community leaders. The university's commitment to the pursuit of excellence in teaching, research, and community service is embedded in a forward-looking approach that combines the best of university traditions and values with innovation. We were pleased to read in The Australian last month that the law faculty at Griffith University was the only one in Australia to rate 100% in terms of student satisfaction and to have all of its graduates either in employment or pursuing further study. This outstanding achievement epitomizes Griffith. It has achieved much in a short period of time. The hallmark of Griffith's activities is the bringing together of disciplines in the development of courses and research activities that meet the changing needs of society. Its activities are enhanced by the university's close links with business and the community, and the value of these links is nowhere more obvious than in the mentoring program, which provides our students with the opportunity to gain valuable work experience and industry connections. I'm sure that our students graduating today from the faculties of arts, education, and law will make valuable contributions professionally and as responsible citizens. Griffith has an international approach to education and one of the most extensive networks of international linkages in Australia. Its international student population is one of the largest in Queensland, and many of them are studying here at the Gold Coast. Griffith also seeks to inculcate an international outlook in its Australian students, who it encourages to study overseas. And last year, 70 Griffith students attended institutions overseas under the university's scholarship and exchange programs. To our graduating students, may I say that now your studies are completed, you are joining an elite group. Because only a small percentage of the Australian population possesses tertiary qualifications. And as members of this group, you can expect to enjoy better employment prospects and hopefully higher salary levels than people who have less education. But education not only brings important social benefits, but also a particular responsibility to work for a better world, to be sensitive and active on issues of social justice, to be competent, ethical, and hardworking professionals. If I was asked what I would wish for the graduates, I would preface my comments by commending all of you on the achievements which already signify your personal determination, energy, and the ability to make differences in your own lives. However, it takes more than determination to succeed. The building blocks provided by this university and the support of your family and friends should never be underestimated. What I wish for you individually throughout your life is good health, good friends, the support and comfort of a special person who loves you, the courage to live up to your ideals and to stand up for your beliefs, the courage to tell it as you see it, even if it is the unpopular view at the time, the divergent view. And in addressing the young graduates in particular, in the years ahead, you will change in time, your career, and the people in your lives will affect this change. How you react will depend on your attitude. You will grow and learn and hear of things that are not always found in books or online. You will discover diverse aspects of the human condition. And I hope that added to the wonderful knowledge you already possess, they will nurture tolerance and understanding. My final hope for all graduates is that your years of preparation to reach this point will be the impetus for much more work and study that will reward you with many years of happiness and fulfillment. And I hope you will always give back to the world in keeping with your education and opportunities. So as we continue with this afternoon's proceedings, I'd again express warm congratulations to each of you and extend to you our best wishes for your lives ahead, and if you want it, a brilliant career. I'd now like to call on the deans who will present the graduates from their respective faculties who are to receive their awards at this ceremony.
Chancellor, Professor David Moss, the Dean of the Faculty of Arts.
Chancellor, I present graduates from the Faculty of Arts who have been granted the following awards. Bachelor of Arts. The first graduand is also being granted the Graduate Certificate in Teaching of English as a Second Language. Kim Alden. Tammy Allen. Sasha Bodell. Amy Bramall. Sam Cleveland. Rodney Greenway. Natalie Harker. Darren Hart. Stephen McKeon. Deborah McPherson. Eric Meredith. Katerina Oyala. Heather Ranger. Erica Saito. Rebecca Scholes. Anthony Smith. Fiona Stown. Congratulations. Ellie Charlotte Starset. Congratulations, Ellie Charlotte. Christina Sullivan. Genevieve Trad. Lisa Van Bremen.
Congratulations, Lisa.
Cassie Walkerdon. Bachelor of Arts with First Class Honours, Cavell Cruikshank. Clifton Evers. Christy Che. Linda King. Megan Montgomery. Shannon Murdoch. Bachelor of Arts with Second Class Honours, Division A, Damien Helgeson. Bachelor of Arts with Third Class Honours, Kai Hinselwood. Bachelor of Arts in Creative Arts, Emma Breen. Astra Buckley. Hannah Brynand. Joe Carey. Ben Daly. Michelle Fitzgerald. Emma Gardner. Drew Jarvis. Michelle Keane. Barbara Christo. Carol Mariano. Michelle Morton. Lisa Rose. Andrew Wallace. Bachelor of Arts in Japanese, Miriam Araujo. Tamra Brown. Kesty Cooper. Cara Dempster. Sarah Deal. Nina Hoyle. Laura Marshall. Tammy Mitchell. Congratulations, Tammy. Sharon Sato. Rebecca Storm. Bachelor of Communication, Brad Blissett. Joanna Chambers. Susan Charlton. Shay Cook. Lee Cox. Nikki Crawford. Tanya Dale. Kelly Denning. Joanna Faulkner. Chancellor, the next graduate has been awarded the Communication Medal for 2000 for the most outstanding academic achievement in a bachelor's degree. Joanita Feldbauer. Gemma Gorman. Fiona Goff. Huda Granfar. Danny Lehman. Joy Lynch. Rebecca Madsen. Yvette Morris. Jodie Munn. Ronald Stefan. Joanna Tan. Haley Turner. Bachelor of Nursing, Sue Marshall. Master of Arts, Qingpei Chang. Leslie Chang. Homi Cheng. Su Yun Choi. Godo Guntoro. Catherine Harriman. Yukiko Helgeson. Joanne Su. Mei Chen Kuo. Maggie Lam. Boris Liao.
Congratulations, Boris.
Yunwei Lin. Chunpei Lo.
Congratulations, Chunpei. All the best to you.
Emmanuel Pratalahaja.
Congratulations, Emmanuel.
Francisca Suryagyaya.
Congratulations, Francisca.
Vanya Wijaja. Chancellor, I present a graduate from the Queensland Conservatorium, Master of Music Studies, James Rhodes. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of graduates from the Faculty of Arts, the Queensland Conservatorium, and the Faculty of Nursing.
Chancellor, Professor Marilyn McMenamin, the Dean of the Faculty of Education.
Chancellor, I present graduates from the Faculty of Education who have been granted the following awards. Bachelor of Education, Caroline Agnew. Sean Orcoing. Ashley Banner. Leanne Barnett. Jacqueline Belden. Chelsea Blythe. Amy Bolshad. Leah Bowden. Lauren Boynton. Abby Bradbrook. Carrie Brown. Leah Marie Brown. Renee Campbell. Kelly Carlson. Tamara Chen. Kate Christopher. Briallen Cook. Nikki Crispy. Catherine Crook.
Congratulations, Catherine.
David Croucher. Amanda Dancy. Jade Davey. Sharon Derrick Fraser. Angela Dibsdale. Stacey Dowling. Tanya Edwards. Leanne Edwick. Chancellor, the next graduate has been awarded the Education Medal for 2000 for the most outstanding academic achievement in a bachelor's degree, Beveline Fagg. Penny Ferguson. Julie Francis. David Glanville. Margaret Hamilton. Anne Harris. Dave Hartley. Yeah,
now, where are you teaching? Another children's coping. Very good. Congratulations.
Trina Harvey. Alana Henderson. Jason Hill. Renee Hinton.
Congratulations, Renee.
Daphne Houston. Shelley Howell. Lisa Hume. Kieran Hungerford. Tamara Isaac. Nikki Jackson. Claire Jamison. Amber Jarvis. Melissa Jones. Michelle Karagalinian. Linda Kidson. Jodie Klopfel. Lisa Krieger. Rebecca Lang.
Rebecca.
Erica Lambden. Vanessa Lawler. Megan Lawson. Rebecca McDonald. Tessa McCarran. Katrina McLaughlin. Sam Mercer. Debbie Miller. Jade Miller. Laura Milne. Chantelle Mizzi. Kelly Moore. Mandy Morehouse. Carly Maroney. Leslie Muir. Leonie Newland. Deborah Newton. Matthew O'Brien. Cherie O'Dwyer. Congratulations, Cherie. Carole O'Neill. Madonna O'Sullivan Roderick. Hayley Olivier. Kylie Pallett. Alyssa Palmer. Naomi Paris. Delma Parker. Bianca Pierce. Catherine Postens. Sarah Preston. Jeffrey Quartermain. Paul Reese. Brett Reese. Brooke Reeves. Gabrielle Sapwell. Amanda Saunders. Amanda. Amanda Shivens. Jennifer Schloss. Elizabeth Scott. Donna Smith. Leonie Staines. Belinda Stanford. Mireille Stevenson. Danielle Stewart. Nicola Swede. Congratulations to you. Catherine Sweet. Congratulations, Catherine. Cherie Todd. Hayley Trengove. Hope Turner Hoschke. Kelly Irwin. Sarah Welsh. Dallas Werder. Linda Weyer. Amy Yates. Graduate Certificate in Higher Education, Glenn Harrison. Tracy Harrison Hill. Graduate Certificate in the Teaching of English as a Second Language, Trevor Balzer. Uda Granfa. Catherine Sadik. Alison Shields. Congratulations, Alison. Kay Stafford. Lauren Thornton. Congratulations, Lauren. All the best to you. Good luck. Master of Education Studies, Robin Schwartz.
Congratulations. All the very best.
Yoshi Sumitomo. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of graduates of the Faculty of Education.
Chancellor, Professor John Dewar, the Dean of the Faculty of Law.
Chancellor, I present graduates from the Faculty of Law who have been granted the following awards. Bachelor of Laws with Second Class Honours, Division A, Kylie Cook. Nicole Simmons. Bachelor of Laws and Bachelor of Business, Lisa Baker. Shannon Butel. Anthony Forrester. Tamara Lawton. Bachelor of Laws with Second Class Honours, Division A, and Bachelor of Business, Mark Bunch. Anna Marie Keeley. Gillian Moon.
You got some friends there.
Laurie Skull. Bachelor of Laws with Second Class Honours, Division B, and Bachelor of Business, Catherine Byrne.
Congratulations to you, Catherine. Have the best day.
John Hannah.
Congratulations to you, Catherine.
Darren Mullally. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of graduates of the Faculty of Law.
Ladies and gentlemen, there will now be a brief musical interlude performed by students of the Queensland Conservatorium, Griffith University.
Nothing's plenty for me. I got no car, got no mule, got no misery. The folks with plenty of plenty got a lock on their door. Seems with plenty sure got to worry how to keep the devil away. Away. I ain't no lock on the door, that's the way to be. They can steal the rug from the floor. That's okay with me, cause the things that I prize, like the stars in the sky, are all free. Oh, I got plenty of nothing, and nothing's plenty for me. I got my girl, got my... No use complaining, got my girl, got my Lord, got my song. Nothing, and nothing's plenty for me. I got the sun, got the moon, got the deep blue sea. The folks with plenty of plenty got a lock on their door. Seems with plenty you sure have to worry how to keep the devil away. Away. I ain't a fretting about hell till the time arrives. Never worry long as I'm well. Never want to strive to be good, to be bad. What the hell, I'm glad I'm alive. Oh, I got plenty of nothing, and nothing's plenty for me. I got my girl, got my song, got heaven the whole day long. No use complaining, got my girl, got my Lord, got my song.
To a graduate who has completed the requirements for both a bachelor's degree of the university and a degree with first class honours. Chancellor, I'm pleased to present a graduate from the Faculty of Commerce and Management who has been granted the University Medal, Clifton Evers. Apologies there, the candidate was from the Faculty of Arts, not the Faculty of Commerce and Management, as my dais brief says. Chancellor, today the university is proud to honour a graduate who has satisfied the rigorous criteria for the award of the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. Chancellor, the following graduate has been granted the degree of Doctor of Philosophy taken in the Faculty of Arts. Dr. Wise's thesis approaches the conventional gap between fiction and philosophy, not as a silence, but as the possibility of writing in a double register, invoking both traditions, in a search for a fuller understanding of creativity. Chancellor, I present Dr. Peter William Wise. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of Doctor of Philosophy graduates.
With the authority of the Council, I shall now confer the degree of the Doctor of the University, and I'd call upon Acting Vice Chancellor Professor Bill Lovegrove to read the citation.
Chancellor, the Council of the University has resolved to award the degree of Doctor of the University to the Honourable Chief Justice of Hong Kong, Andrew Kwok Nang Lee. Andrew Kwok Nang Lee was born in Hong Kong in 1948. He was educated in Hong Kong at St. Paul's Coeducational Primary School and St. Paul's Coeducational College until the completion of Form 3. He finished his secondary education in England and graduated with a Master of Arts and Master of Laws from Cambridge University. He was called to the English Bar in 1970 and the Hong Kong Bar in 1973. In 1998, he was appointed Queen's Counsel. Andrew Lee was appointed as the Chief Justice of the Court of Final Appeal, Hong Kong Special Administrative Region, on 1st of July 1997. Before this most prestigious appointment, he practiced at the Hong Kong Bar. Chief Justice Lee has a long record of public service. He was a member of the Executive Council and served as Chairman of the University and Polytechnic Grants Committee and the Land Development Corporation. He has also served as Deputy Chairman of the Inland Border Review, as a member of the Law Reform Commission, the Securities Commission, the Standing Committee on Company Law Reform, the Banking Advisory Committee and Judicial Services Commission. Chief Justice Lee has made significant contributions to education as the Vice Chairman of the Council of Hong Kong University of Science and Technology, as a member of the Board of Governors of Lignan College, and as Vice Chairman of the Council of St. Paul's Coeducational College. He is also a trustee of the Friends of Tsinghua University Law School Charitable Trust and guest professor of that university. In the past, he was also steward of the Hong Kong Jockey Club. Chief Justice Lee's achievements have been recognised by honorary degrees awarded by the Hong Kong University of Science and Technology, the Baptist University, the Open University of Hong Kong, and the University of Hong Kong. He was made an honorary bencher of the Middle Temple in 1997 and an Honorary Fellow of Fitzwilliam's College, Cambridge, in 1999. It is fitting that Griffith University should honour the Honourable Chief Justice of Hong Kong, Andrew Lee, in recognition of his distinguished contributions to the legal profession, education, and to the community. Chancellor, it is with the greatest pleasure that I present to you the Honourable Chief Justice of the Hong Kong Administrative Region, People's Republic of China, Andrew Kwok Nang Lee, for admission to the degree of Doctor of the University.
Now call upon the Honourable Chief Justice of Hong Kong, Andrew Lee, Doctor of the University, to deliver our occasional address.
Chancellor, Acting Vice Chancellor, members of the faculties, graduates, students, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I wish to begin by expressing my sincere and heartfelt gratitude to the university for the high honor conferred on me and for the kind and generous citation. I am most proud to be admitted to the eminent rank of doctor of this distinguished university. It is an award which I accept with deep humility and which I show treasure. It gives me great pleasure to receive this award from an Australian university. The relationship between Australia and Hong Kong is a close and long-standing one. There is and has been substantial trade and investment between us, and we are bound by ties of family and friend. Quite apart from tourists, there are many Australians living in Hong Kong, and there are many Hong Kong people living in Australia. We share many common goals and values as open and free societies, and we have similar legal systems based on the common law tradition. There are a number of Australian lawyers working in Hong Kong, both in the private and the public sector, including the judiciary. And we are fortunate to have three eminent Australian jurists, including two former Chief Justices, Sir Anthony Mason and Sir Gerard Brennan, serving as non-permanent judges on our Court of Final Appeal, Hong Kong's final appellate court, established in 1997 to replace the Privy Council. To all students graduating today, whether with a bachelor degree or a postgraduate degree, I wish to offer my warmest and heartiest congratulations. With your dedication and hard work, you have deservedly earned your degrees. I'm sure all graduates will agree with me when I say that you owe a great debt of gratitude to your families and the teaching staff of the faculty. It is a debt of honor which I'm sure you will never forget. Throughout the past years, they must have given you their unstinting support and wise guidance. Without them, I doubt if you will be here today. They must be very happy today and have every reason to be very proud of your achievements. To them, I also wish to extend my congratulations and best wishes. It is now some 3 decades ago since I started my working life after graduation from university and the completion of professional training. In the late 1960s, the world was very different from what it is today. World affairs were dominated by the Cold War. Major events included the Six Days War in the Middle East and the Vietnam War. China was at the height of the Cultural Revolution. It was closed to the outside world. The first human heart transplant was carried out, Concorde. The world's first supersonic airliner was completed. Man set foot on the moon for the first time. I use man advisedly, since to the best of my recollection, no female was on that flight. Stars like Elizabeth Taylor and Maggie Smith were Oscar winners, and the Beatles and the Rolling Stones were the fashion of the day. Compact discs were unknown, let alone personal computers and the internet. The last 3 decades have seen the most momentous changes in the world. We have seen massive and the most amazing advances in science, technology, and medicine, and in every field of human endeavor. And there have been sea changes in the geopolitical landscape. The Cold War is gone. The Soviet and Eastern Bloc has disintegrated. European Union is developing. Asia has been an area of growth, and in modern and strong China, my motherland has emerged. And Hong Kong, my homeland, is now one of the most modern cities of China. It was reunified with China in 1997 under the imaginative concept of one country, two systems, exercising a high degree of autonomy. That concept was the brainchild of the late Deng Xiaoping, and is enshrined in the Basic Law, Hong Kong's mini constitution. Under the basic law, Hong Kong enjoys a high degree of autonomy with its separate system and its own institutions, including an independent judiciary. It contains constitutional guarantees for the rights and freedoms which are at the heart of Hong Kong's separate system and way of life. In the past 4 years, the concept of one country, two systems has been successfully implemented, and this is accepted and perceived to be so both within and outside Hong Kong. As provided for in the basic law, the previous legal system based on the common law has continued as before. One interesting feature of the post-1997 new order is the establishment of the Court of Final Appeal, which, as I have already mentioned, was established to replace the Privy Council as our final appellate court. It is a court of 5 judges, and I have the honour to preside in it. One of the 5 judges is a non-permanent judge, selected by me from a panel of non-permanent judges. The judges on the panel include 3 eminent jurists from Australia and New Zealand, respectively, and 3 British law lords. Our judgments are readily available on the Hong Kong Judiciary's website. I believe that we have made good progress in the formative years in establishing the court's reputation both within and outside Hong Kong. At this meaningful presentation ceremony, I cannot help but reflect that by the time the students graduating today reach my stage of life, we will be approaching the year 2035. What will the world be like then? What does the future hold? The 21st century will be an era of rapid change. It is certain that in the new millennium, we will see many developments in all spheres of society, with increasing globalization having a major impact. Above all, the continuing advances in science and technology, particularly information technology, will have a far-reaching impact in all areas of human endeavor. And Asia, including Australia, is confident that the 21st century will be the Asian century. Many have predicted and continue to predict that by as early as 2020, Asia, and China in particular, will account for a very major slice in the world's economy. This will enhance Asia's economic power and its influence in world affairs. Looking into the future, we can only be certain of one thing. The pace of change in all fields is likely to accelerate. Amongst these rapid and accelerating changes, I would venture to suggest to the students graduating today that it is important that the values and the goals we live by should remain constant and should endure. It is important that we should hold steadfast to them. Abide always by the enduring values of honesty and integrity. Strive always for excellence. Make no compromises with mediocrity. Seize every opportunity, for it may well not knock again. There will be ups and downs in life. Sometimes the sun will shine on you. At other times, life will be stormy. Sometimes the sailing will be plain. At other times, you will be going through rugged territory. But there is no turning back, and progress you must. Tackle what life throws at you with courage and have faith in your ability to overcome adversity. For sweet are the uses of adversity, as Shakespeare pointed out. Remember that the things taught at university are not an education, but only a means to an education. There are no limits and boundaries to learning, and all of us need to learn for life, exposing ourselves all the time to new knowledge and skills. And we must also continue to learn from experience in the university of life. Ships are safe anchored in the harbour, but this is not what ships are made for. The students graduating today are fortunate to have received an excellent university education. Leaving the portals of this university, you have concluded a stage in your life journey and will be embarking on your next stage. You will find working life challenging, exciting, and rewarding. I wish you good fortune and every success and happiness. Thank you.
I'm extremely pleased to be able to thank today's guest speaker. Before doing that, I'd like to offer to you, the graduates, my own congratulations on the achievements you're celebrating today. Graduations are important times for you as you leave the university and enter a new stage of life, but they're also an important time for we who stay at the university to reflect on what we do and how we may do it better. In his stimulating address today, Chief Justice Lee has spoken about the inevitable nature of change in your future and in ours. He's given us a wonderful insight into his own historical role in the changing legal system in his country of Hong Kong within China. His words, however, are important to you and to us, where he's emphasised looking for the opportunities that change brings with it rather than looking for the obstacles. You may like to think about the growth of your own university and the rapid change that has occurred in Australia in the last 15 years, in which we have been able to move from a single campus to one of Australia's largest universities. I think that's the lesson, or one of the lessons, you should take with you into your future of change. With those words, let me just ask you to join with me in thanking Chief Justice Lee.
Ladies and gentlemen, the ceremony is now concluded. When the music begins, please rise and remain standing as the dais and staff processions, along with the graduates, retire. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the graduation ceremony for the graduates of the Faculties of Engineering and Information Technology, Health Sciences, and Nursing and Health. In a few minutes, the graduation ceremony will commence. The procession of dais and staff parties will enter. I will signal to you when you are to rise and remain standing until all of the members of the stage party are seated. May I take this opportunity to request that you turn off all mobile phones and pagers, and may I also remind you that flash photography is prohibited within this auditorium. Ladies and gentlemen, the Chancellor, Ms. Lenine Ford, will now address us.
Adjunct Professor Brian Finn, AO, former CEO of IBM Australia. Professor Dennis Lincoln, our Acting Vice Chancellor. Councillor Dawn Critchlow, the Gold Coast City Council. Members of the Griffith University Council, distinguished guests, colleagues, graduates, ladies and gentlemen. It is the custom for Griffith University and its guests to gather and celebrate the conferral of academic awards on its graduates. And on behalf of the Council of the University, I'm pleased to extend a very warm welcome to everyone present for this graduation ceremony. This occasion holds special significance for our graduates because this evening, in the presence of family, friends, and the entire university community, your dedication and hard work are recognized and rewarded. I would like to extend a very special welcome to Adjunct Professor Brian Finn, AO, who is the former CEO of IBM Australia and is an adjunct professor with the Graduate School of Management. He will receive the university's honorary degree, Doctor of the University, and will deliver this evening's occasional address. Griffith is one of the largest multi-campus universities in Australia and is formed by an integrated network of 6 campuses stretching from South Bank on the Brisbane River to here on the Gold Coast. From these campuses, Griffith serves the higher education needs of its students and its related communities in Brisbane and the Gold Coast region, as well as nationally and internationally. The Gold Coast is Griffith's fastest growing campus and one of the most modern in Australia. Since 1990, Griffith University has invested more than $110 million in the development of teaching and research facilities at our Gold Coast campus to both meet local demand for tertiary study and to support the region's economic development initiatives. There are nearly 8,000 students, including 1,200 fee-paying international students, enrolled in one of the 51 undergraduate or 46 postgraduate degree programs on offer. It is also host to leading research bodies, including the National Heart Foundation Research Center, the Genomics Research Center, and the newly established Center for Biomolecular Science and Drug Discovery under the directorship of Professor Mark von Einstein. Himself a Griffith graduate, Professor von Einstein was awarded the Australia Prize in 1996 for pharmaceutical discovery and the development of the anti-influenza drug Relenza. Griffith University and the Gold Coast City Council are jointly funding a feasibility study into the proposed development of a technology park at the Gold Coast campus. And we're confident that such a park, with its facilities for research and development and high technology business incubation, would provide a significant and continuing impetus for the development of knowledge-based industries in this region. As an active member of the Gold Coast community, Griffith is concerned that residents of this region do not enjoy the same level of access to higher education as other parts of Australia. So Griffith is pursuing a campaign to lobby the Commonwealth Government to increase by 3,000 the number of publicly funded student places allocated to the Gold Coast region. If successful, this will bring the number of student places allocated to the region up to the national average. Now, this campaign has the strong support of prominent local business as well as community leaders. The university's commitment to the pursuit of excellence in teaching, research, and community service is embedded in a forward-looking approach that combines the best of university traditions and values with innovation. And the hallmark of Griffith's activities is the bringing together of the disciplines in the development of courses and research activities that meet the changing needs of society. Its activities are enhanced by the university's close links with business and the community. And the value of these links is nowhere more obvious than in the mentoring program, which provides our students with the opportunity to gain valuable work experience and industry connections. I'm sure that our students graduating tonight from the faculties of Engineering and Information Technology, Health Sciences, and of Nursing and Health will make valuable contributions professionally and as responsible citizens. Griffith has an international approach to education and one of the most extensive networks of international linkages in Australia. Its international student population is one of the largest in Queensland, and many of them are studying here at the Gold Coast. Griffith also seeks to inculcate an international outlook in its Australian students, who it encourages to study overseas. Last year, 70 Griffith students attended institutions overseas under the university's scholarship and exchange programs. To our graduating students, may I say that now that your studies are completed, you're joining an elite group, because only a small percentage of the Australian population possess tertiary qualifications. As members of this group, you can expect to enjoy better employment prospects and hopefully higher salary levels than people who have less education. But education not only brings important social benefits, but also a particular responsibility to work for a better world and to be sensitive and active on issues of social justice, and to be competent, ethical, and hardworking professionals. If I was asked what I would wish for the graduates, I would preface my comments by commending you on the achievements which already signify your personal determination, energy, and the ability to make differences in your own lives. However, it takes more than determination to succeed, because the building blocks provided by this university and the support of your family and friends should never be underestimated. What I wish for you individually throughout your life is good health, good friends, the support and comfort of a special person who loves you, the courage to live up to your ideals, and to stand up for your beliefs, the courage to tell it as you see it, even if it's the unpopular view, the divergent view. And in addressing the young graduates in particular, in the years ahead, you will change because time, your career, and the people in your lives will affect this change. But how you react will depend on your attitude. You will grow and learn and hear of things not always found in books or online. You will discover diverse aspects of the human condition. And I hope that added to the wonderful knowledge you already possess, they will nurture tolerance and understanding. My final hope for all graduates is that your years of preparation to reach this point will be the impetus for much more work and study that will reward you with many years of happiness and fulfillment. I hope you will always give back to the world in keeping with your education and your opportunities. So as we continue with this evening's proceedings, I'd again express warm congratulations to each of you and extend to you our best wishes for your lives ahead, and if you want it, a brilliant career. I'd now like to call on the deans who will present the graduates from their respective faculties who are to receive their awards at this ceremony.
Chancellor Professor Barry Harrison, the Dean of the Faculty of Engineering and Information Technology.
Chancellor, I present graduates from the Faculty of Engineering and Information Technology who have been granted the following awards. Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering, Kong O Young. Bill Beam. Andrew Brinley. Fred Cha. Matthew Cross. Christian Forsyth. Max Gonzalez Mendoza. Jay Hugovost. Cameron Marshall. Paul McPheat. Stemson Go. Chancellor, the next graduate has been awarded the Engineering Medal for 2000 for the most outstanding academic achievement in a bachelor's degree, Todd Remmers. Trent Shepherd. Scott Walter. Daniel Woodrow. Joshua Woodward. Joshua. Donna Yusuf. Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering and Bachelor of Business Management, Brett Taylor. Bachelor of Information Technology, Will Blakey. Owen Bourne. John Caldwell. Alex Sorrentino. Jason McCullough. Tony McNeil. Warwick Mitchell. Chancellor, the next graduate has been awarded the Information Technology for 2000 for the most outstanding academic achievement in a bachelor's degree. Marcello, go. Darren Phillips. Saba Prasad. Lincoln Ramsey. Paul Rosso. Regan Tablan. Diana Terry. Ken Uduno. Bachelor of Information Technology and Bachelor of Exercise Science. Chancellor, the next graduate has been awarded the Exercise Science Medal for 2000 for the most outstanding academic achievement in a bachelor's degree. Cameron Collard. Bachelor of Multimedia, Heath Bewley. Kieran Blythe. Congratulations, Kieran. Good luck to you. Sharice Booth. Congratulations, Kieran. Mark Campbell. Congratulations, Mark. Steve Coles. James Davison.
Congratulations, James. All the best.
Lee Dowsett.
Congratulations, Lee. All the best.
David Edwards.
Congratulations, David. Good luck to you.
Michael Fraser. Bradley Gabriel. Brett Gobi. Brad Harrison. Peter Healy. Kurt Lane.
Congratulations, Kurt.
Chancellor, the next graduate has been awarded the Multimedia Studies Medal for 2000 for the most outstanding academic achievement in a bachelor's degree, Nick Nimris. John Miles. Michael Nitsky. Danny Pollitt. David Richardson. Stacey Moan Sitherith. Dawad Takaran. Chris Trigger. And David Watson. Master of Information Technology, Srini Chandra. Sridhar Chinta. Vicky Chu. Vengat Gunreddy. Srinivas Reddy Hangamahalikari. Guru Hong. Surabhi Jain. Raman Kumar. Ian Lai. Chajan Lovejoo. Wexon Lai. Rebecca Lowe. Yusha Mentanaramani. Sukhat Patek. Samantha Pirelli. Bunyat Ratanjit Panjori. Suda Samproy Prasakar. Sanyi Sikuchi. Paul Simpson. Yi Sun. Kiyan. Leah Yuan. Hao Zhang. Master of Philosophy, Yinjong Chen. Chancellor, that concludes the presentations of the graduates of the School of Engineering and Information Technology.
Chancellor, Professor Roger Willis, the Dean of the Faculty of Health Sciences.
Chancellor, I present graduates from the Faculty of Health Sciences who have been granted the following awards. Bachelor of Biomedical Science, Justin Bodie. Rick Bolton. Fiona Couchman. Kieran Davidson. David Della. Megan Harvey. Heather Lee Malam. Lisa Martin. Kirsty Millmore. Chancellor, the next graduate has been awarded the Biomedical Science Medal for 2000 for the most outstanding academic achievement in a bachelor's degree, Diane Moses. Sylvia Papp. Robin Smith. Simone Stanton Cook. Peter Thurick. Riley White. Emma Windsor. Bachelor of Exercise Science, Matthew Anderson. Scott Chambers. Canon Della Santa. Angela Dix. Megan Farrell. Carly Forrester. Tony Forshaw. Emily Golan. Melissa Howell. Matt Jenner. Terry Kirkup. Gary Kerwin. Kinga Kowalewski. Jason Kronk. Brett Lloyd. Erin McGregor. Peter Nowell. Thomas Pascoe. Congratulations, Thomas. Luke Roberts. Congratulations, Luke. All the best to you. Adam Russell. Congratulations to you, Adam. Surendran Savapathy. Voltaire Saldana.
Congratulations, the very best.
Catherine Sievers.
Congratulations, Catherine.
Ben Tindall.
Congratulations, Ben.
Amelia Wiggins. Bachelor of Exercise Science with First Class Honours, Andrew Wing.
Congratulations to you, all the very best.
Bachelor of Exercise Science and Bachelor of Business, Forrest Butcher.
Congratulations to you, all the very best.
Simon Clark. Andrew Doak. James Graham.
Congratulations, James.
Tony Green.
Congratulations, Tony. Best to you.
Justin Keevers. Bachelor of Health Science, Taryn Boyle. Kirsten Deem. Bree Gillam. Tracy Gretton. Megan Harvey.
Congratulations, Megan.
Kenneth Hilliard.
Congratulations, Kenneth.
Angela Johnson.
Congratulations, Angela.
Ben Maron. Benjamin Marshall. Chancellor, the next graduate has been awarded the Health Science Medal for 2000 for the most outstanding academic achievement in a bachelor's degree, Donna Mills. Anita Pettigrew.
Congratulations, Anita.
Stephen Royal.
Congratulations, Stephen.
James Sundholm.
You've got some friends there, James. Congratulations.
Madeline Tovell. Laura Willems. Bachelor of Health Science with First Class Honours, Claire Bellis.
Congratulations, that's a great thing.
Christopher Day. Suzanne Owen. Elsa Pratt. David Tyndall. Jessica Vandalilli. Bachelor of Health Science with Second Class Honours, Division A, Sarissa French. Carlene Rooney. Carly Venados. Bachelor of Science in Environmental Health, Rachel Opat. Come on, Rachel. Come on, Rachel. Olivia Ann Robinson. Congratulations. Master of Nutrition and Dietetics, Melanie Cheek. Tricia Compton. Debbie Fisher. Julian Glover. Melanie Hedrick. Peter Irwin. Catherine Mortimer. Leanne Mundy. Fiona Smith. Sarissa Woodworth. Fiona Woolcock. Master of Sports Physiotherapy, Cindy Burke. Congratulations to you, Cindy. Nicholas Schwartz. Congratulations, Nicholas. Kath Young. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of graduates from the Faculty of Health Sciences.
Chancellor, Professor Anne McMurray, the Dean of the Faculty of Nursing and Health.
Chancellor, I present graduates from the Faculty of Nursing and Health who have been granted the following awards. The Bachelor of Nursing, Emma Bailey. Chancellor, the next graduate has been awarded the Nursing Medal for 2000 for the most outstanding academic achievement in a bachelor's degree, Helen Beckman. Leah Belsner. Via Kumari Bhaskar. Rachel Blair. Carly Bland. Nerali Bost. Congratulations. Sarah Bradsworth. Joanne Brockett. Christy Brown. Rachel Cacamo.
Congratulations, Rachel. Good luck to
you. Bernadette Carrig Groves.
Congratulations, Bernadette.
Gay Chant. Natalie Chant. Penelope Conley. Ann Cooper. Patricia Cosgrove. Annette Delaney.
Congratulations, Annette. All the best.
Tanya Dusen.
Congratulations, Tanya. All the best.
John Dixon.
Congratulations, John. Tanya's in the top right here.
Mary Georgievsky. Kirsty Eckersley. Julia Ellis.
Julia.
Catherine Ellison.
Catherine.
Samantha Fish. Shari Fleming. Rebecca Gardner. Joe Guerin. Janet Gazelle. Laura Gibson.
Congratulations, Laura.
Emma Green.
Congratulations, Emma.
Melissa Gray.
Congratulations, Melissa.
Jody Hankinson. Warren Harlow. Belinda Hillsley. Andrea Hinks. Cheryl Hutchison. Haley Ingram. Kylie James. Jacinda Johnson. Nicholas Keane. Victoria Kelly. Catherine Leslie.
Congratulations, Catherine.
Finbar Lorden.
Finbar, where are you?
Joanne McKay. Sharon Madgers. Kathia Maranzano. Ronald McAndrew. Leanne McAuliffe. Heidi McCollum. Sally McLean.
Congratulations, Sally.
Carolyn Merrifield. Nadine Mullerin. Rebecca Noble.
Rebecca.
Linda Knott. Kathy O'Donnell. Candace Page. Elizabeth Paul.
Elizabeth.
Colleen Parcell. Beck Piercy. Wendy Patterson. Jason Platt. Sherry Puffett. Matthew Roberts. Amanda Sadler. Karen Salter.
Congratulations, Karen.
Ellen Scanlon.
Congratulations, Ellen.
Shirley Schaefer. Victoria Seeger. Candace Sheens. Bree Sherry.
Congratulations, Bree. All the best.
Gary Shorthouse.
Congratulations, Gary. All the best.
Leanne Slinger. Justine Smith. Wayne Smythe.
Congratulations, Wayne. All the very best to you.
Faith Squires.
Congratulations, Wayne.
Keith Stevens. Trudy Stevens.
Friends are really relatives.
Katrina Taylor. Kathleen Taylor. Joe Tier.
Congratulations.
Jordana Tonkin. Claire Towers. Rita Virtanen. Kurt Werner. Kirsty Winterstein. Paula Lee Wood. Melissa Yao. Elizabeth Zanis. For the Graduate Certificate in Critical Care Nursing, Jan Cook. Cara Harrington. Mary Briley. Vanessa Rumley. The Master of Emergency Nursing, Marilyn Wright. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of graduates from the Faculty of Nursing and Health.
Ladies and gentlemen, there will now be a brief musical interlude performed by students of the Queensland Conservatorium, Griffith University.
Quei pennacchini, quel cappello, quel...
quella chioma, quell'aria brillante. Non ci andrai farfallone amoroso, notte e giorno d'intorno girando, belle belle turbano il riposo, narcisetto aroncino d'amor. Delle belle turbano il riposo, narcisetto aroncino d'amor. Fra guerrieri può far bacco, gran mustacchi stretto sacco, schioppo in spalla, scialba al fianco, collo dritto, muso franco, un gran casco, un gran turbante, molto onor, poco contante, poco contante, poco contante. Della fandango, una mace per il fango, per montagne, per valone, con le nevi al saglioni, al concerto di tromboni, di bombardi, di cannoni, che le palian tutti tuoni, all'orecchio fan fischiar, non ti avrai, che te nacchini, non ti avrai, quel cappello, non ci avrai, quella chioma, non ci avrai, quell'aria brillante. Non ci andrai farfallone amoroso, notte e giorno d'intorno girando, delle belle turbano il riposo, narcisetto aroncino d'amor. Turbano il riposo, narcisetto aroncino d'amor. Cherubino alla vittoria, alla gloria militar. Cherubino alla vittoria, alla gloria militar. Alla gloria militar, alla gloria militar.
Chancellor, Professor Mark Fernane, Dean, Postgraduate Education, will now present a candidate for the Award of University Medal. This will be followed by the presentation of candidates for the Award of Doctor of Philosophy.
Chancellor, the University Medal may be awarded in recognition of academic excellence to a graduate who has completed the requirements for both a bachelor's degree of the university and a degree with first class honours. Chancellor, I am pleased to present a graduate from the Faculty of Health Sciences who has been granted the 2001 University Medal, Andrew Norman Richard Wing. Chancellor, today the University is proud to honour graduates who have satisfied the rigorous criteria for the award of the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. Chancellor, the following graduate has been granted the degree of Doctor of Philosophy taken in the Faculty of Engineering and Information Technology. Dr. Warani has studied the application of Gestalt principles in the development of automated intelligent systems. Her research may improve computer management of all forms of visual information by providing higher level, more intuitive methods for accessing and manipulating images and video. Chancellor, I present Dr. Asta Warani.
Chancellor, the following graduate has been granted the degree of Doctor of Philosophy taken in the Faculty of Health Sciences. The research of Dr. Haupt has used a new method to measure the expression and to investigate the role of matrix metalloproteinase genes in human breast cancer. Chancellor, I present Dr. Larissa Haupt. Chancellor, the following graduate has been granted the degree of Doctor of Philosophy taken in the Faculty of Nursing and Health. Dr. Patterson has explored the current role of nurses employed in general medical practices to identify and analyse their scope of practice and contribution to primary health care in Australia. Chancellor, I present Dr. Elizabeth Patterson. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of Doctor of Philosophy graduates.
With the authority of the Council, I shall now confer the degree of Doctor of the University, and I call upon Acting Vice Chancellor Professor Dennis Lincoln to read the citation.
Chancellor, the Council of the University has resolved to award the degree of Doctor of the University to Adjunct Professor Brian Finn, AO. Chancellor, Thomas Brian Finn was born in 1937 in Newcastle upon Tyne, England. He is a real Geordie, as you will hear very soon. He was educated at St. Cuthbert's Grammar School, Newcastle upon Tyne, and since then has followed the fortune of the lads, who play for what he says is one of the world's great soccer teams, Newcastle United. Brian Finn's long and distinguished business career included over 35 years with IBM in marketing, software development, and from 1975 to 1993 in general management. He has lived and worked in the United Kingdom, the United States of America, India, Hong Kong, and Australia. From 1975 to 78, he was responsible for IBM's business in Afghanistan, Bangladesh, India, Nepal, and Sri Lanka, and was based in New Delhi. From 1978 to 1980, he was responsible for IBM's business throughout Asia and was based in Hong Kong. In 1980, he became chief executive of IBM Australia and served as chairman from 1991 to 1998. During this period, he was also appointed as a director of Telstra and served in that capacity from 1991 to 1996. As well, he was chairman of City Power from 1994 to 95, director of Primac from 96 to 98, and director of Thor Australia from 1993 to 1999, and chairman of Sydney Ports Corporation from 1995 to 1998. Since 1996, Brian has been an independent director and chairman of Impart Corporation, one of the six cooperative multimedia centres established through seed funding from the federal government's Creative Nation program. Griffith is a shareholder in Impart and has greatly valued Brian's leadership and stewardship of Impart that has contributed to the creation of a respected organization with sales of customized on-learning products to major government and private enterprises, both nationally and internationally. Brian Finn is also chairman today of M2M Corporation, deputy chairman of Southcor and Powertel, and a director of AXA Asia Pacific and KidsNet. Brian Finn has served with distinction on many important public bodies. He served as chairman of the Australian Education Council review of post-compulsory education in 1991, which produced an influential report known as the Finn Report. He was a member of the Business Council of Australia from 1981 to 1993, chairman of the Council of the National Science and Technology Centre from 1998 to 1997, and chairman of the Australian National Training Authority from 1992 to 1995. He is currently a member of the Queensland Innovation Council. Brian Finn is a Fellow of the Institution of Engineers Australia, a Fellow of the Academy of Technological Sciences and Engineering, a Fellow of the Australian Computer Society, a Fellow of the Australian Institute of Company Directors, and a Fellow of the Australian Institute of Management. As an adjunct professor in the Graduate School of Management, Brian Finn has been an active contributor to the work of the university. His contributions range through a series of corporate issues from international human resource management to business ethics. Brian Finn was the chair of the university's Information Services Policy Committee from its inception in 1998 to 2000. He brought to this role a thorough understanding of contemporary industry issues in the area of information and communications and a business perspective. Brian Finn's outstanding contributions to the community were recognized when he was appointed an Officer of the Order of Australia in 1990 for services to business, industry, and education, and when he received an Honorary Doctor of Letters from the University of Western Australia in 1999. It is fitting that the Griffith University should honour Brian Finn in recognition of his distinguished contributions to the business community and to the university. Chancellor, it is with the greatest pleasure that I present to you Thomas Brian Finn, AO, for admission to the degree of Doctor of the University.
I'd now like to call upon Adjunct Professor Brian Finn, AO, Doctor of our University, to deliver the occasional address.
Chancellor, Acting Vice Chancellor, members of Council, University staff, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, and most especially graduates, good evening. As you might appreciate, this is a very special evening for me. I'm really delighted to receive an honorary degree from the university, and I'd like to thank you, Chancellor, on behalf of the university, for recognizing me in this way. In the course of my business career, I came to realize how vitally important education is to the success and progress of business, as well as to the personal development and enrichment of individuals. For that reason, I feel that I've been privileged to play a small part in helping support the fine work done by our education institutions in general, and Griffith University in particular. Long may your success and progress continue. My real pleasure this evening, however, is to be sharing it with you, the graduates. Have you received the degrees you've earned, and as you celebrate that wonderful achievement with friends and with family. I'm sure this is a special event for everyone here, and you must be bursting to have the formal proceedings end so that you can get on to that celebration. And here am I, taking up precious time and holding you all back. You'll groan when I tell you that I was asked to speak for 15 minutes. But frankly, the thrill of receiving my degree is matched only by my nervousness at having to address such an important audience and say something that might be of interest. So I do have some good news. I intend to be through within 10 minutes, and you know you can trust me because I'm a doctor. First, thank you. First and foremost, I'd like to offer my congratulations and good wishes to the graduates, and to address my remarks for the next few minutes to you. I'm sure that you must be so pleased to have completed your degree programs and to be attending this ceremony today. May I suggest to you, however, that today should not mark the end of your studies and your education, but rather that you should view it as an important milestone in a lifetime of learning. The days when you could earn a degree and enter a profession in which you spend the remainder of your working lives are long gone, and the pace of change is picking up. Perhaps I might illustrate what I mean by reflecting on some incidents in my own life and career that brought home to me just how rapidly change has happened and what it's meant in day-to-day living. In the mid-1970s, I was living in Houston, Texas, working on a software development project at the Johnson Space Center for my company, IBM. My mother, who was then in her 70s, came to visit us, and in the process of showing her around, I took her to the Space Center. Among the exhibits were several vehicles that had been into space, some around the moon. They'd returned and they'd been put on display. My mother was in awe, and I asked her what she thought of it all. What she said pulled me up with a jolt. She said that she found it all very hard to believe, because she could remember as a little girl being aware of the news that the Wright brothers had become the first people ever to fly. It really brought home to me how far we'd come in one person's lifetime. My father's background also showed me in a very different way how much things have changed on the social front. He died many years ago, but I had occasion recently to go through some of his old papers. Among them was the legal document that registered his apprenticeship as a fitter and turner. It was dated 1919, and it bound him for a period of 5 years to a company of masters where he was apprenticed, for pay of 7 shillings a week, that's $1 at today's exchange rate, rising to double that in the fifth year. It was interesting to note that his father had to sign the document and was obligated to make sure that his son complied with the rules of the masters, rules that are quite bizarre by today's standards. Let me mention just 3 of 11 offenses that carried fines if you were caught in the act. Number 1, for washing hands or making any other preparation to leave work before the whistle blows, fined 1 day's pay. For using offensive language to any foreman, fined 2 days' pay. And the one that amuses me most, for exceeding the limit of 30 minutes in the lavatory each week, 1 day's pay. I promise you I didn't make it up, and you can see that things have changed in the workplace, thank goodness. Finally, I might briefly reflect on what I've seen happen in the computer industry since the days when I joined IBM just over 40 years ago in 1959. At that time, there were very few computers being used commercially around the world, a few hundred at most, and it wasn't until a year or two after I joined that the transistorized computer replaced valve machines and became commercially viable. I recall in 1961 making my first computer sale to a big customer. The computer was quite large and needed a special air-conditioned room about 8 meters square. It was too expensive for most firms to buy outright, so they rented it for around $5,000 a month. It took a team of engineers about a week to commission and install, after which the customer spent several months getting their own applications working. Each week, the computer would be taken out of service for a day for an engineer to perform routine maintenance. Breakdowns once or twice a month weren't unusual, and it didn't have any ability to communicate with another computer. If you fast forward that to today, or rather a couple of months ago, I arranged the purchase of a new computer for a friend. I installed it myself in less than an hour, after which it was fully operational. It sits on a desk in a normal living room, and it will operate indefinitely without any need to switch it off. It has vastly more storage, facilities, and computing power than the machine I mentioned earlier. And it can exchange text, voice, and images with other computers pretty well anywhere in the world. And the cost, all up, about $2,000, less than half the cost of 1 month's rent for the machine I first sold. But enough of looking back. I hope those fleeting personal memories might have touched a chord with parallels in your mind about how quickly the things we think are wondrous today become commonplace and then totally out of date. All of which returns me to where I started. Keeping pace with change doesn't just happen. You have to make a determined effort to stay up to date if your career is to progress and if you're to get the most out of life. Learning, whether on the job or by attending classes and studying, is the key to it all. So I urge you, don't view your hard-earned degree as the end of your education. Think of it as a passport to a lifetime of learning. That way, you'll be able to enjoy and to relish all the change brings to our lives, personal and professional. With a little luck and a lot of hard work, you'll be able to make your own mark on directing the course of change and shaping the future of our world. One final word, if I may. In some respects, our lives have become dominated by technology, by things. And if I've learned anything at all, it's that people matter much more than technology, or more than anything else for that matter. Pretty well everything we do depends on our relationships with other people. As you go about building your personal and professional future, I urge you to pay most attention to the people in your lives. I assure you that in doing so, you'll improve your chances of success, but more importantly, you'll have a much better time. Again, my congratulations and good wishes to you as you graduate today. Congratulations, too, to the people who have helped and supported you in reaching this important point. Well done. Thank you.
It is my pleasure on behalf of all of us here this evening to extend a word of appreciation to Brian Finn for his occasional address. Before doing so, I would like to extend my congratulations to all the graduates here tonight. I appreciate the work that is taken, and I appreciate that it has also involved a lot of friends and family in the process. I think you're all to be acknowledged for that effort. Graduations are, of course, a time for celebration. They're a time of transition for many of you. And they're a time for reflection. And I think Brian Finn has reflected with us tonight on some of his own experiences and that of his parents. And he has drawn our attention to just the scale of change that we have experienced in just one lifetime, and of course the increasing pace of that change. And I suppose, as a leading figure in IBM, he has really been in the hot seat as technology has changed, I think, in certainly the last 30 years out of comprehension. Of course, we're no better placed now in 2001 to say what it's going to be like in 2030. But I can rest assured it's going to be very, very different. Your degree, as Brian has indicated to you, should not be viewed as an end in itself, but to quote what I think are some very nice words, it should be seen as a passport to a lifetime of learning. And of course, we now have to believe you, now that he's a doctor. It causes me to question his 35 years in IBM. I commend you to work hard into the future, and as Brian says, with a little luck, you have every chance of participating in the changes ahead and indeed in shaping your own future. Please join with me in thanking Dr. Brian Finn, AO, Doctor of the University, for his stimulating address.
Ladies and gentlemen, the ceremony is now concluded. When the music begins, please stand and remain standing as the staff and dais parties, along with the graduates, retire.